We have time for Pastor Eric to continue his teaching regarding eldership and membership. This is bi-directional relationship. So how can we live out to love one another in this aspect? I think that will actually help us, help the world see that we are different and draw them toward the Lord. So we just can give all the time to Pastor Eric and I think some translation.
No.
Need some translation? You need interpretation? Oh, okay.
Yeah? Okay. Thank you. Right. Okay. So. Okay. Well, again, thank you for having me here. It's a great honor. Remember how I said at the beginning of the sermon that me and my wife were the first ones to hold Ian after he was born? Yeah, I don't know if you can see. So, yeah. So, yeah. Yeah. Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So everybody is famous.
Okay, yes. Ian is famous. But yeah, so this is Pastor Wong's grandson. This is my wife holding him. So it's little Ian. Okay. Anybody see? Isn't that great? Yeah. Yeah. So he was just a couple hours old.
Hello.
So.
Oh,
there you go. There you go. Isn't that great? Yeah. Yeah.
Hello.
There you go. Okay, so. I've heard people say that I look very young. Okay, so this is my wife, Paige.
This is my wife.
Okay, today is her birthday.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, okay. So how old do you think she is?
You guess how old she is.
What? 35. Yeah, we already have here this morning. We talked earlier today. So I have 35, 45. 75? What?
35.
35.
Okay, 35.
We've had 45.
45.
Anybody else? Anybody else? 40?
40.
Okay, so based on those guesses, how old do you think I am?
You guys guess how old I am.
58.
What? 58? Okay, so. Okay. Yeah. Okay. There you go. There you go. There you go. Oh. So, all right. One more time. So, her birthday is today.
Yes.
I'm 54. And she turns 52 today. 52. Isn't that crazy? Yeah. When we were on our honeymoon 31 years ago, people thought she was my daughter. Isn't that a riot? And that's happened many times actually through the years. It really has. But no, we've been married 31 years. We have two sons, Evan and Caleb.
Evan and Caleb.
You won't be able to see it very well, but I'll pull up a picture anyway. Let me see. Ah, here we go.
有时候有些人误会说他太太是他女儿。
So there we all are. Okay. Evan is the long-haired one, and he's 24. 24. Caleb is the shorter-haired one. His hair is really short right now. And he's actually on a mission trip in Estonia. So yeah, he just got there a couple days ago, and he'll be there till the end of June. And so if you think of Caleb, pray for Caleb. He's with a bunch of friends. They're sharing the gospel with college students.
He has two sons, the older one is 24, so you can pray for him while he's in Estonia.
There you go. Yeah. Okay. Well, I just wanted to say thank you again for having me here. Just a little bit more about me. I've been a pastor for 29 years.
我当牧师28年。
Mm-hmm. 29 years, yes, almost 30.
大概30年。 So, yeah.
I've been a preaching pastor for 24 years.
我讲道讲了 24年.
Yeah. I just resigned.
我刚刚辞职.
And I turned over the church to a young man I trained to be a pastor.
我把教会交给一个年轻人，是我训练他的.
Yeah. So I'm still there as an elder.
我还在那边当长老.
But I'm no longer on staff.
可是我已经不在他们的职员的名单上.
And I work for an organization called XL Ministries.
我为一个机构服务，叫就是领袖训练的一个机构。
Yeah, and we help churches develop good godly leaders.
我们帮助教会来训练领袖，就是按着神心意的领袖。
When a man graduates from seminary and becomes a pastor,
当一个人从神学院毕业以后做牧师,
he usually lasts less than 5 years.
一般他不会不是超过五年。
85% of all pastors that started a church don't finish.
85%在教会服事的，他们没有不能够继续的来服事。
It can be a very difficult job.
是一个非常困难的一个工作。
But if God calls you to it, it's wonderful.
但是要是神呼召你，那是非常好的一个侍奉。
So what we want to do at XL is to help pastors last.
所以我们的事工就是要帮助这些牧师能够持久的来服事教会。
And so we offer training so that a pastor, a young man, knows what he's getting into when he becomes a pastor.
所以我们给他训练，让他们知道说，要当牧师有哪一些需要做的。
Yeah. And for me, again, it's such an incredible blessing to turn my church over to someone that I know is really equipped to do it.
然后我感到很兴奋，因为我能够交给一个我所信任的年轻人来持续的牧养教会。
And I still get to be there too.
然后我还是继续的能够在那里。
Amen. Amen. Well, thank you again. I did want to say, are there any questions based on the sermon that I just preached?
你们有没有什么问题关于刚才的讲道？
Well, you said everything clearly.
Okay. No questions. Good. I like that. But please feel free. I've been doing this type of work where I've been an elder and a pastor for a very long time. I've also helped a lot of people become pastors. I've helped churches get better at doing leadership stuff. So please feel free. Yes, ma'am.
So what's the difference between like our church follow and submit to elders with the Catholic Church follow and submit to the Pope?
Yeah. So again, we don't do that. Okay, your church doesn't do that. We don't do that. So the Catholics believe that the Pope is in some ways supernatural. Okay, and that he speaks. When he speaks, it's infallible. He's speaking the words of God. Okay, and even if he doesn't read the Bible or say the Bible, okay, and you run into all kinds of issues with that. And then the Pope and then the priests are given a special position within the church, a hierarchy, okay? Mm-hmm. And they're considered different than you and me, mm-hmm. All right? Mm-hmm. So the Bible doesn't teach that, okay? Mm-hmm. The Bible teaches that elders and leaders are simply mature Christians, okay? Mm-hmm. People that have come on mm-hmm. up. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm saying too quick. 天主教他们顺服他们的神父有什么差别？是不是一样的？那是不一样的，因为天主教徒他们把这个神父当成是，甚至是有点是高在上，一个神的地位。他说的一切话都像是从神来的话，可是其实不应该是这样子，应该是从圣经里面来教。Oh, sorry. Real quick, yeah, just real quick, I'll say it. So again. The Bible teaches that there is no special priest class.
圣经教导说没有一个特别的一个族群，就是超越其他人的。
In fact, the Bible calls all of us holy ones or saints.
圣经里面说我们都是圣徒。
That's because we're in Jesus and he's the Holy One.
因为我们是在耶稣基督里面，我们就是圣徒。
So we don't need a higher priest class.
所以我们不需要有这个特别的祭司的这个职分。
We don't need to go to a priest to get to God or Jesus.
我们不需要通过一个祭司来到耶稣面前。
Jesus tells us to come to him directly.
耶稣说我们可以直接到他面前。
Yeah, okay. And then also, Catholicism teaches that you must be saved by doing certain things.
天主教是教导我们说，我们需要做一些事情才能够得救。
The Bible says believe in who Jesus is and what he did.
圣经里面教导我们就是要信靠耶稣基督跟他所做的。
No works, just a gift.
不是靠着行为而得救。
Okay, does that answer your question? You can clarify a little more?
That answers that question.
Okay, all right.
We can have lots of questions. I love questions. Okay, all right. Go ahead.
If Pastor Wang that's retired, can he become an elder in this church?
That's your decision. It's the church's decision. Okay, so ideally, I mean, for me, okay, and I'll just use my example. Ideally for me to resign from what I did, okay, and be able to stay is really a blessing. Okay. So, and I still preach there on occasion. Like I'm going to preach there 2 weeks from today.
You are playing an elder role.
I am. Yeah. But I'm no longer supported. I'm no longer supported by the church. Okay. So I'm not paid. Right. Okay. But our church in particular, we in our constitution have said that we want to have at least one elder who is paid so that he can devote himself to the teaching of God's word. Okay, he doesn't have to be distracted by other stuff. Okay, that has been me for the last 24 years. Okay, but now I get to be distracted to go to other churches and teach about this. So, and XL pays me to do that as well. So
it's very, very nice.
But yes, in fact, ideally, I think this is how it should go.
Okay,
I am.
黄渊的问题就是说，要是王牧师有一天退休了，他还能不能继续当教会的长老？那他是说，是按着我们教会的宪法，可是应该是可以的。像他自己本身，就是他虽然不在教会里面服事了，可是他其实还是在教会里面服事，他偶尔还是会回去讲道，虽然他不是他们的受薪人员之一，不拿薪水，对，可是他还是会继续的在教会服事。
Okay. So I try to be. So right now, our church is going through a transition time. I resigned, and Pastor Josh can't start fully until July 1st. Okay. He has to finish up his current job. He's a police officer.
Wow.
Okay.
So he has already resigned, but the new pastor.要到七月一号才能够正式开始。他是一个警察。
He'll resign in June.
他会在六月份辞职。
His daughter's graduating from high school.
他女儿要高中毕业。
He's moving.
他要搬家。
And he's quitting his job.
他要辞职。
Very busy time for Josh.
是非常忙碌的一件。
So me and several others are helping preach. Josh is preaching a lot. But over these, until the end of June, there's going to be people preaching. And in fact, on Father's Day, Isaac Wong is going to preach. So, yes. Yes.
所以我还会继续的在教会里面帮忙，直到这新的牧师来为止。然后，在父亲节的时候，王牧师的儿子会在教会里面讲道。
So, good news. Colorado's 2 hours behind. Okay. So, church is just now starting. In Colorado. So you can maybe watch him during Sunday school hour. Okay, put it up on YouTube and go. So,
所以在哥拉多州，他们的时间比较慢，他们是比我们慢两个小时，所以现在他们大概要开始他们的崇拜，所以我们这个主日学结束以后可以去看他们的崇拜。
Okay, so back to the question. I think it's best if there is a group of elders in place. Okay. An extent of age, so older, wise brother, okay, older, a little bit younger brother, okay, and then, yeah, and then, you know, younger still and younger still, and then we just sort of go, yeah, so we kind of grow, and then ideally, when I step aside again to have Josh in place, ready to go, huge blessing, okay.It takes around 18 months to find a pastor. When a pastor resigns or retires or leaves, it takes around 18 months. That's very hard on a church. Very hard.
所以最理想的这个长老团应该是有年纪比较长的，有稍微年轻一点的，还有更年轻的。所以当比较长的他离开以后，这些年轻人就能够接续。他说要找一位教会要找一位新的牧师，一般需要18个月才能够找到。
So when I resigned, or I announced my resignation in November last year, and my last day would be January 28th.
我是去年11月跟向教会辞职的，可是我最后一天是在1月28号。
When I announced my resignation, without even saying things, people knew that Pastor Josh was going to come into place.
当我辞职的时候，大家就知道说另外一位牧师 Josh 他会接续我的工作。
So we went ahead and we wanted to the congregation to say yes, we want Pastor Josh.
所以我们就让会众来决定。
So we had a vote.
我们投票。
And that was 100% support.
然后有100%的人支持这位新的 Josh 牧师。
My last day was January 28th.
我最后一天是1月28号。
Josh's first day was January 29th.
Josh 牧师1月29号就开始了。
And that is a huge blessing.
所以对我来说是神很大的祝福。
And I think that's how ideally church should go.
我觉得这样子对教会是非常好的。
It would be wonderful for the Lord to raise up someone for when the Lord causes or wants Pastor Ishu to step aside, that there's someone right in place that can just come on in. Who knows you, who you know, you love, you already love, you know who he is, he's taught you.
所以最理想就是能够在我们当中有一位他愿意出来当牧者，当王牧师退休以后，这个人就能够出来，因为他认识我们，我们认识他，我们也爱他。
And the transition is very smooth.
所以这个就很容易的就能够转换到新的位牧师。
One of the many benefits of an elder board.
所以这个就是有一个长老的制度的好处之一。
More questions?
还没有问题。
Remember, I love questions.
我很喜欢问题。
I just spent an hour monotone this way, you know, love to have some back and forth.
我喜欢我们能够有交流。
This question is to Pastor Wang. We have interviewed a young pastor who will be graduating this May.
Yeah.
So is he coming here or not?
Yeah, at least it's an update. We're supposed to let you know. He already signed. Take this off. So suppose he will come in July, early July. 弄传道他口头上已经答应了，所以七月初他就会大概七月，因为他也有很多的需要搬家什么的，所以七月一定会来。那因为他身份上面，我们会等他从学生的他转成R1啊，就是要宗教的。的签证啊，如果等他转成了 R1 之后呢，我们就会要请弟兄姐妹有正式会员的通过，他可以成为教会的教牧人员啊。那我们就开始进入我们教会的这个，我们是有一个contract， 就是有点像是契约啦，有点像一个做法，所以基本上到七月应该就会来。
Amen. Okay. Anybody else?
还没有人有问题。I'm asking them.
Sure. All right. So if you have your Bibles, turn to 1 Thessalonians 5.
帖撒罗尼迦前书第五章。
I mentioned this passage in the sermon.
我讲到的时候有提到这段经文。
But it's a very good one to spend a little more time on.
但是这是非常好一段经文，我们可以多花一些时间来看。
Okay, so the Thessalonians were a very healthy church.
帖撒罗尼迦是一个很健康的教会。
Okay, look at how Paul describes them in chapter 1, verses 2 through 10. Do you want to go ahead?
保罗他形容他们。
Do you want to just read it?
1 Thessalonians
chapter
1,
2 through 10.
1, okay, 2 to 10. Okay. 我们为你们众人常常感谢神，祷告的时候提到你们， 在神我们的父面前不住的纪念你们因信心所做的功夫，因爱心所受的劳苦，因盼望我们主耶稣基督所存的忍耐。被神所爱的弟兄啊，我知道你们是蒙拣选的，因为我们的福音传到你们那里，不独在乎言语，也在乎全能和圣灵，并充足的信心。正如你们知道，我们在你们那里为你们的缘故是怎么样为人，并且你们在大难之中蒙了圣灵所赐的喜乐，领受真道，就效法我们，也效法了主。甚至你们做了马其顿和亚该亚所有信主之人的榜样，因为主的道从你们那里已经传扬出来。你们向神的信心不但在马其顿和亚该亚，就是在各处也都传开了，所以不用我们说什么话，因为他们自己已经报名我们是怎么样进到你们那里，你们是怎么样离弃偶像归向神，要服侍那又真又活的神，等候他儿子从天降临，就是他从死里复活的那一位，救我们脱离将来愤怒的耶稣。
That's a very healthy church.
他是个非常健康的教会。
Isn't it great when the pastor or the whoever's writing says, I thank my God every time I think of you?
当牧师能够说为这教会来感谢神，每次想到你们的时候就感谢神，这是非常美好的。
But we never want to be a church that just says, okay, we've made it.
可是我们不要说我们已经达到我们这美好的标准，我们不需要再努力了。
And so in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 1,
所以在帖撒罗尼迦第四章第一节的时候，
I'll read it in English and then Lee can read it in Chinese. Finally then, brothers, we ask and urge you in the Lord Jesus that as you receive from us how you ought to walk and please God, just as you are doing, that you do so more and more.
弟兄们，我还有话说。我们靠着主耶稣求你们，劝你们，你们既然受了我们的教训，知道该怎么样行，可以对神的喜悦，就要照你们现在所行的更加勉励。
Okay. We want to have a healthy fellowship, right?
我们要有健康的团契。
You want a strong church.
我们要有个很健康的教会。
And Paul here tells the Thessalonians what that looks like.
保罗在这里告诉帖撒罗尼迦，健康的教会是怎么样的。
One of the instructions he tells them is 1 Thessalonians 5:12.
其中一个在帖撒罗尼迦五章十二节。
And 12 and 13, he says this: We ask you, brothers, to respect those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work. Be at peace among yourselves.
弟兄们，我们劝你们敬重那在你们中间劳苦的人，就是在主里面治理你们、劝解你们的，又因他们所做的工，用爱心格外尊重他们，你们也要彼此和睦。
Okay, similar to the sermon, because the word of God is clear in this area, let us pursue sustaining a healthy church.
神的话在这方面是非常清楚的，我们要追求要有一个和睦的教会。
One of the things I said in the sermon is that any organization that's going to work well requires honor and obedience to a hierarchy there.
任何一个机构要健康，就是要有这个尊重，权柄，顺服权柄。
And again, this is just how God has set the world up.
这是神的设计。
And this implies or impacts even our walk with Jesus.
这影响我们跟耶稣基督的关系。
Out of thankfulness and joy for what he has done for us, not trying to earn salvation.
我们对，因为对他的感恩，他救赎我们。
Because we have salvation in Christ.
因为我们在主里面已经有这个救恩。
As a free gift.
是一个免费的礼物。
We live the rest of our lives in loving obedience and thankfulness to Jesus for what he has done.
所以我们就是用一生，我们怀着感恩的心来遵守，行出他所要我们做的。
It's easy to say that I love Jesus.
我们很容易说我们爱耶稣。
But Jesus says to me and you, prove it by obeying me.
可是耶稣说，你证明给我看，就是用你们的行动，你们的顺服来证明。
If a child says they love their parent,
要是一个小孩说他爱他的父母，
but then goes behind their back and lies to them,
可是在他背后却说一些谎话。
They're not really loving their parents.
那他们不是真正的爱他们的父母。
Okay. So, same with us. We can say we love Jesus.
我们也可以说我们爱耶稣。
But we need to demonstrate that love through obedience.
但是我们需要以行动来证明我们对他的爱。
Jesus says this in John 14:6.
耶稣在约翰福音十四章六节怎么说？
John 14:21, my bad.
约翰福音十四章二十一节。
He who has my commandments,
你们有我的命令的
，and keeps them,
你遵守的
，he is the one who loves me,
就是爱我的
，and I will love him,
我也会爱他
，and disclose myself to him,
我会向他显明我自己。
What that means is that we know that Jesus loves us, we know that God loves us.
我们知道耶稣爱我们，神也爱我们。
But as we lovingly obey him, we experience that love more and more and more.
当我们愿意顺服他的时候，我们就能越能够经历他对我们的爱。
The relationship becomes sweeter and sweeter.
这个关系就会越来越甜美。
So in this passage here, in 1 Thessalonians 5, 12 and 13,
在这段经文里面，
Paul instructs the Thessalonians to honor their leaders.
保罗劝勉弟兄姐妹要尊重他们的领袖。
To respect them because of what they're doing in your life and teaching you and admonishing you, you are to esteem them very highly in love.
要敬重他们在我们中间的劳苦，治理我们。
Okay. As you look at this text, and I'm going to ask a question, and I want answers, okay? Okay. Tell me why, based on this passage right here, the Thessalonians should give honor to the leaders of their church, and then, of course, by extension, why you and I should give honor to the leaders of our church. Tell me why, based on this text.
按照这段经文，就是为什么帖撒罗尼迦人要敬重他们的领袖，然后我们自己为什么要敬重我们的领袖？按照这段经文
，They are a gift from God.
They are from God. And that's it. So he says there, respect those who labor among you and are over you, where? In the Lord.
我们要敬重他们，因为是他们是在主里面的。
So I said this strongly in the sermon.
我在讲道的时候已经讲过。
That elders and pastors are put in place by God.
长老和牧师是教是神放在那里的。
No matter how we actually do it within our church.
不管我们在教会里怎么样执行
，It's the Acts 20:28 passage. The Holy Spirit makes us overseers.
在《使徒行传》里面二十章二十八节是圣灵
，okay.
来做成的。
So your leaders belong to the Lord.
所以我们的领袖是属神的。
You belong to the Lord as well.
你们也是属神的。
The leader has deep, heavy responsibility to shepherd you.
领袖有很很重的责任要去牧养。
And you have deep responsibility to honor and respect.
我们也有很重的责任要去尊重他们。
Okay, 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 1 through 4.
彼得前书五章。
We'll look at verse 2. Peter writes to the elders of the churches that whom he's addressing.And he says to the elders, shepherd, this is verse 2 of chapter 5, verse 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 2. Shepherd the flock of God that is among you, exercising oversight, not under compulsion, but willingly, as God would have you.
Okay, 彼得前书五章第二节，务要牧养在你们中间神的群羊，按着神旨意照管他们，不是出于勉强，乃是出于甘心。
Okay, so...All of us are called in whatever we do in word or deed to do all for the glory of God, right?
我们不管做什么，我们都是像是为神做的。
So an elder, his calling is to elder or shepherd well, not ultimately for you, but for God.
那个长老被呼召出来服事，他主要是要顺服神。
It's vital that when you have an elder in place or a leader,
当我们有长老的时候。
They understand that.
他们需要明白他们是为神在做。
Because if they're using the church for their own sort of advantage,
要是他们是为了自己的利益,
then they will hurt you.
但他会伤害教会。
But if they recognize that God is the one who has them in place and they are accountable to him, things will go well.
当他们承认他说是神呼召他们，他们要向神交账的话，那他们就会做好这个职分。
So think about it this way. I'm the youngest in my family. Okay, I have lots of stepbrothers, but I have one full brother, Greg.
在我家里面我是最小的，我有一个是亲生的哥哥。
Greg is 7 years older than I am.
他比我大七岁。
When I was young,
我小的时候
people didn't come after me because of my older brother, Greg.
大家不会来找我麻烦，因为我哥哥在保护我。
Was it because of who I was that they didn't come after me?
不是因为我自己。
It's because of who Greg is.
可是是因为我这位哥哥 Greg.
Yeah, because Greg would beat them up.
因为 Greg 会把他们揍一顿。
So, that's kind of a negative illustration.
这是一个比较负面的一个例子。
But we don't mess with each other because God is our older brother, as it were. He's actually our father, Jesus, our older brother. And if you mess with me, you mess with him.
我们要以恩慈相待，因为我们就是属于神的。耶稣像是我们的长兄，我们要是对彼此不好，
so,
他会来跟我们算
账。As an illustration, just an illustration, we want to honor those who are over us because they belong to God.
我们要敬重那些管理我们的，因为他们是在神的权柄下。
Okay, does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, any questions there?
有没有什么问题？
Okay, now here's the real challenging one. So they're elders because God has done it. Can you see anything else in this text that says they should receive honor because of this?
First Thessalonians
chapter 5, verses 12 and 13.
我们回到帖撒罗尼迦前书第五章十二到十三节。
How about this one? I'll go ahead and say it. Okay. The leadership should receive honor because you love them.
这领袖他们要被尊重，因为我们爱他们。
And just ask yourself, do I love the people God has put over me in the Lord?
我们要问一下，我们真的爱这些神的领袖吗？
So, this must have been an issue with the Thessalonians because Paul wouldn't have written it if it wasn't, right? So he says to esteem them very highly in love.
所以在帖撒罗尼迦应该他们有这样的问题，所以保罗才劝勉他们要敬重他们的领袖。
The church is to be marked by all kinds of characteristics.
教会需要有一些特征。
We're to serve one another.
我们要彼此的服侍。
We're to have compassion and we're to help one another.
我们要有怜悯的心，彼此的帮助。
We're to forgive one another when we sin against each other, right?
我们要彼此赦免。
Yeah, we're to be Christ-like ourselves, we're to be pursuing holiness.
我们要追求圣洁，像主耶稣一样。
We are to practice hospitality.
我们要对外人要接待外人。
Bringing people into our lives, our homes, just things we do.
接待他们在我们自己的家里面。
But the clearest characteristic, and maybe the most important one from which all these other ones stem, is love.
但最重要的特征就是要有爱。
Paul tells the Colossians in chapter 3, verse 14, and above all of these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony.
所以保罗劝哥罗西的人说，最重要的就是要用爱来彼此的相待。
And this love is agape love. It's unconditional, Christ-like love.
这种爱是无私的爱。
So, before you were saved, did God love you?
我们在被得救以前，我们是否有神的爱？神是否爱我们？
Yes, he did.
神是爱我们的。
Okay. God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
当我们还是罪人的时候，主就为我们而死。
Paul says in another place in Romans, while we were enemies, Christ died for us.
在另外一处就说到，当我们还是与神为敌的时候，他已经为我们死。
God so loved the world,
神爱世人,
that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish. Meaning,
神爱世人，甚至将他独生子赐给我们，叫一切信他不至灭亡。
Meaning that if we don't believe in him, or before we believe in him, we are worthy to perish.
就说要是我们没有信靠他，我们就是会灭亡。
So, God loves us even when we are wicked sinners.
所以神爱我们，当我们还是与他为敌的时候。
I was saved when I was 17.
我是17岁的时候得救。
I could tell you horrible stories about things I did before that.
我有很多的故事，就是我之前做了一些很不好的事情。
Nothing beyond normal for an unbelieving teenager.
对一个还没有得救的年轻人来说，不是太特别。
One of the things that I didn't realize was bad, but I loved to do was take the name of the Lord in vain.
我喜欢就是滥用神的名。
I would scream out his name, and I loved how it made people angry.
我用神的名让人生气。
Okay. Third commandment, do not take the name of the Lord your God in vain.
第三个诫命就是不要滥用神的名。
And it isn't just simply using God's name in a profane way.
不只是滥用神的名。
It's living or talking or thinking in any way that dishonors him.
我们就是说话、思想活出来的，
That questions or assaults his character.
然后让人不尊重神。
So when the Bible says do not lie,
当圣经说不要说谎。
It isn't that simply God tells us not to lie.
不只是神叫我们不要撒谎。
God is truth.
因为神是真理。
Truth is his character.
真理是神的一个特征。
So when I lie, I am assaulting God's character. I'm assaulting him.
当我说谎的时候，我是在亵渎神的名。
Every sin, in first and foremost, is an attack against God.
每一个罪其实就是在攻击神的属性。
Even if I lie to you,
即使我对你说谎，
I'm lying to the God of truth.
我是在对神撒谎。
God loves us when we're like that.
当我们还是罪人的时候，神就爱我们。
And that is the love that we are to share with one another.
所以我们也要以这样的爱来彼此的相爱。
That's very hard, right?
是非常的困难。
But in Christ, you can do all things through him who strengthens you.
但靠着耶稣基督，我们能够做万事，靠着他加给我们的力量。
How hard was it for Christ to go to the cross?
耶稣上十字架是多么的困难。
Father, remove this cup from me.
他祈求神说：“把这杯挪去。”
Not my will, but yours be done.
不是按着我的旨意，乃是按着你的旨意。
So if I'm struggling with anger towards somebody,
当我在在挣扎对人有这个敌意的时候。
My heart might say, Lord, do away with them.
我可能会说，神，求你把这些人拿走。
My flesh says that.
我的肉体会这么说。
But not my will, but yours be done.
但是是愿你照你的旨意行，不是按照我自己的旨意。
You loved me, Lord, when I was like that.
当我自己还是这样的时候，主，你就先爱了我。
Now I have your love that I can convey to that person.
那我现在我有你的爱，我可以把这个爱来。
Now, that's the serious stuff, right?
这是比较,
but in our relations here,
我们之间的关系,
same love.
也是要有这样的爱。
I hope it's easy for us to love each other.
我希望我们很容易爱, 彼此相爱。
It can be difficult at times.
有时候是有挑战的。
But the command is here, isn't it?
但这是神的命令。
We are to esteem our leaders in love.
我们要按着神的吩咐来尊重我们的。
Just as you are to demonstrate love to each other,
我们也要彼此的相爱。
You are to demonstrate that love to your leaders.
我们对我们的领袖也要有这样的爱。
Okay. When love motivates our actions,
当爱来激动我们，
things tend to go pretty well.
一般就会事情比较顺利。
So again, in the parent-child relationship,
在一个父母跟孩子的关系当中。
If the parents are committed to loving their children and pushing them or leading them to Jesus,
当父母爱孩子，要把他们引向基督的时候，
and the children are taking seriously the command of God to honor our mother and father,
当孩子愿意顺服来尊重父母的时候，
so you have these two things coming together.
所以你有两样。
Parents desiring to love their children in such a way that they are well.
父母想爱孩子，希望他们好。
Children desiring to honor their parents according to God's will.
哦，孩子愿意照着神的旨意来。
Nice home life.
这样子的生活会。
Nice home life.
家庭生活会很美满。
Okay. Now, we're broken.
我们都是破碎的。
I'm definitely not the perfect dad.
我不是一个完美的父亲。
My wife is the perfect mom.
我太太却是完美的母亲。
She's not. She's in church right now. You get what I'm saying. And my boys are not the perfect sons.
我的孩子也不是最完美的孩子。
But by God's grace, all four of us love Jesus first.
可是，因为神的恩典，我们能够在主里面。
And therefore we have a nice relationship.
所以我们有美好的关系。
Same thing in the church.
在教会里面也是。
I'm committed to loving God.
我愿意照神的旨意来爱神。
I'm committed to blessing you.
我愿意来祝福你们。
Things are going to go pretty nicely.
事情就能够比较顺利。
Love covers a multitude of sins.
爱能遮掩许多的罪。
Okay. So, that's the question. Are you living in obedience to this directive? Are you esteeming your leaders in love?
我们有没有遵守神的这个命令来尊重我们的领导、
okay. 领袖。Thirdly, here from this text, the leadership should receive honor because of what God has called them to do.
我们的领袖他们要受到我们的敬重，因为他们是被神呼召出来的。
They are in the Lord and they are to admonish you.
他们在主里面要劝勉我们。
Now, admonish has a lot of different meanings that we can talk about.
劝解有很多不同的意思。
It can mean to challenge.
它可能是要挑战。
But it also means to comfort.
也可能是安慰。
To educate,
也是教导,
to instruct,
也是, 指导。
So when I see admonish as an English speaker, I think that's kind of a harsh word. I admonish you.
看到这个字有点, 是蛮有挑战的一个字。
But in the meaning of the apostle, it's an all-encompassing word of help.
但是, 保罗用这个字，他主要是讲到帮助的意思。
Sometimes that help needs to be a strong word, right?
有时要帮助一个人也需要就是用强烈的言语。
Sometimes that word needs to be soft.
有时候需要比较温柔的。
Okay. Regardless, the elders are called to do this.
无论如何，长老都需要做到这个。
And it can be hard because it's hard to go to people that are struggling or they're in sin, and you need to confront them.
这是一个挑战，因为有些人他们在挣扎，在犯罪当中，他们不一定会愿意听劝。
A lot of pastors or a lot of people just avoid that.
很多牧师就避免去对这些人说话。
It's unloving to not talk to each other about our weaknesses.
但是不去面对这些，不去对他们劝勉的话，是不爱神的表现。
If I love my child, I say I love my child, but I see him doing something destructive, like maybe getting drunk every weekend.
要是我说我爱我儿子，但是同时看到他在做一些不好的事情，像在滥用酒精的话，
And I don't stop him,
我没有阻止他，
I don't love him.
那我就是不爱他。
Amen. Okay. Yeah, and that's hard, but sometimes that's what's needed to do.
虽然很难，可是我们需要去做。
Much of the time, pastors have great joy in what they teach.
多数的时候，牧师有很多的喜乐在教导上。
Many years ago, I had a gentleman come into my office.
很多年前有一位男生来到我的办公室。
A little older than me.
比我年纪大一点。
And he said, Pastor, I've been addicted to cocaine for 30 years.
他说，牧师，我已经我上瘾，这个对这个大麻上瘾30年。
I'm like, I don't know what to do.
我说我不知道怎么办。
Do I need to send him away to some specialist?
我需不需要把他送到一个专家那里？
But God said, Eric, talk about me.
可是神说，你就说关于我。
Talk about who I am.
说我是谁。
So I quoted to him Psalm 16:11.
所以我就对他分享这个诗篇16篇11节。
Yeah. What it says is that in your presence, it's David praying to God. He says, in your presence is fullness of joy.
这是大卫的祷告，他说在你面前我有满足的喜乐。
At your right hand are pleasures forevermore.
在你右手中有永远的福乐。
So I told my friend,
所以我告诉我的朋友,
you are trying to find joy in something that doesn't give joy.
你没有在正确的东西上寻找喜乐。
You need to find your joy in God.
你需要在神里面找到这个喜乐。
Okay, this is a miracle of God.
这是神的一个奇迹。
He stopped and has never gone back.
他就没有再吸大麻，还没有。
It's nothing to do with me.
对，不是我所做的。
All I did was read God's word.
我只是把神的话语告诉他。
That's all I did.
那就是我。
That to me is one of the greatest memories of pastoral work I have.
这是我一个非常深刻的一个记忆。
Again, all I did was open God's word and read it.
我就是把神的话语打开给他看。
It's an incredible joy when that happens.
当这样的事情发生的时候，真的带给我很大的喜乐。
I hope and pray that you will see that in your own life when you bring the word to bear into someone's life.
我也希望你能够经历这样的喜乐，当你与人分享神的话的时候。
And that's something that all of you should be doing. I would hope and pray that, you know, if you know someone who's caught up in something that ultimately doesn't satisfy.
当我们看到人他们在寻求一些不能真正满足他们的时候。愿我们也能够用神的话语帮助他们。
That you could bring the word to bear in their lives in such a way.
我们能够用神的话语来鼓励他们，帮助他们。
So learn the Bible.
所以我们要学习圣经。
And go to people that know it really well and have spent their life studying it so that you can be equipped to do that.
我们能够向那些已经很懂得圣经的，向他们来学习。
This is what we do.
这是我们所做的。
This is why we're older. Elders are genuinely a little bit older because they have some experience and they know the Bible very, very well.
长老一般就是年纪比较长的，他们很认识圣经。
Yeah. So, you should honor your leaders because of what they do.
我们要敬重我们的领袖，因为他们所做的。
Okay. If the elder or the pastor is not admonishing you in the Lord, he is... Oh, sorry.
要是长老跟牧师没有劝解我们，
He is in sin.
他就是在犯罪。
In other words, if you or you find someone who needs help,
要是你看到有人需要帮助的话，
and the pastor doesn't bring that help through the word,
牧师没有借用神的话语来帮助他，
then he's not obeying God himself.
那他没有来遵守神的命令。
Here's 2 Timothy 4, 1 and 2.
在提摩太后书。
So Paul writes to Timothy, and he says this, I charge you. Okay, this isn't like, okay, you might want to do this. 2 Timothy 4, 1 and 2. He says, I charge you. I'm telling you to do this, Timothy. This is an order from the Lord. I charge you where?I charge you in the presence of God.
所以保罗就是嘱咐提摩太在神面前。
And of Christ Jesus.
在主耶稣基督面前。
Who is to judge the living and the dead?
他是要来审判活人死人。
By his appearing and his kingdom.
凭着他的显现和他的国度。
Preach the word.
要传道。
Be ready in season and out of season.
无论得时不得时。
Reprove, rebuke, and exhort.
要责备，要警戒，劝勉。
With complete patience and teaching.
用百般的忍耐跟各样的教训。
That is what an elder is to do.
这是长老的责任。
Very weighty responsibility.
是非常沉重的责任。
And you need to honor them in that.
所以我们要敬重他们。
Support them in that.
我们要来支持他们。我们要为他们祷告。
Okay, pray for them in that. A theologian named A.W. Tozer.
有一个神学家 A.W. Tozer
said this: What comes into your mind when you think about God?
当我们想到神的时候，有什么事情进到我们脑海里
？Is the most important thing about you?
那是就是最就对我们自己是最重要的事情。
Even if someone doesn't believe God exists, that is the most important thing about them.
要是有人不相信神的存在，那就是他们最重要的一个特点。
What you think about when it comes to God directs how you live your life.
我们怎么样来想神，会影响我们怎么样来生活。
Every person that's alive is a theologian and or a philosopher.
每个活着的人都是一个神学家跟一个哲学家。
What you're thinking about who God is and your relation to Him directs how you live.
我们想神是怎么样的，我们跟他的关系会影响我们怎么生活。
So it's important that you understand what God's word says about Him.
所以我们需要了解神的话怎么样来形容神。
The message of salvation and living well for the glory of God is contained in the Bible.
神的救恩跟怎么样活出神的荣耀已经在神的话语当中。
God has called certain men in the church to bring that to bear in your life.
神呼召一些弟兄来做这样的工作，来劝勉。
As a pastor, sometimes some people will be struggling with something. Might be a death, some sort of loss, lost a job, didn't get a promotion, things like that.
身为牧师，我看到有时会中他们在因为亲人的过世或失去工作，他们在挣扎。
They stop coming to church because they're sad.
他们不继续来教会，停止来教会。
I'll reach out to them in about, you know, 2 or 3 weeks.
我会在几个星期后来去找他们。
And invariably,What's happened is they've stopped coming to church, they've stopped reading the Bible, and they've stopped praying.
他们不来教会的同时，他们也不读圣经，也不祷告。
Whenever someone's having some sort of spiritual struggle, I always ask that question.
当他们在挣扎的时候，我总会问他们。
Are you reading God's word? Are you praying? Are you staying in God's church?
你有没有在读圣经？有没有祷告？有没有来教会？
We wanna flee when things hurt.Right?
当我们生命有些问题的时候，我们总想逃避。
God tells us to lean in to what He's doing.
但神的话是叫我们更要来寻求神。
One of the saddest things is when a church is going through an issue of whatever kind.
当教会在面临一些挑战的时候。
I'm going to say this harshly, but I mean it harshly. People leave because they don't love the church.
Okay, 我比较严重的来对你们说。有些人他们离开教会是因为他们不爱教会。
When things get tough and people leave,
当这个状况比较困难的时候，有些人离开教会。
They're not loving the church.
他们是不爱教会。
That makes sense.
这个
yeah, okay, all right. So, our church, South Boulder Bible Church,
我们的教会
in our constitution.
我们的宪法。
We have a statement that says this.
有这样说。
For the spiritual health and development of our church,
为了教会的灵命上的健康。
This church will consistently strive to have at least one elder.
这个教会应该有至少有一个长老。
Whose primary responsibility,
他最主要的工作。
While not limited to this, will be the weekly consistent ministry of prayer and Bible teaching.
他主要的工作就是要领导大家来祷告跟教导神的话。
Okay, this man may be referred to as the senior teaching or lead pastor.
这人可能就是教会的主任牧师。
This church will strive to provide for this man all the necessary resources he needs to do to fulfill this all-important task.
教会应该供应他一切的一些的资源，让他能够来完成他的任务。
Okay.That's a way to honor.
那是我们敬重他的一个方式。
Okay. Teaching the Bible is so important.
教导圣经很重要。
That the person who's given the primary responsibility in the church needs to have the time to be able to do it and do it well.
这个主要教导我们的，他要有一切的资源，让他能够来实行他的任务。
As your church grows,
当我们教会增长的时候，
you may find it necessary to hire more than one full-time pastor.
我们可能需要多过一位的全职的牧师。
Amen, praise and glory.
感谢主。
If that's what God has.
要是你们有。
Regardless of how many.
不管是几位。
Honor them.
我们都要敬重他们。
Honor them. Because of they belong to God.
因为他们属神。
You love them.
因为我们爱他。
And what they're doing is so important.
而且他们所做的是非常的重要。
Okay. Now, this honor is not an unquestioning, unthinking honor.
但这个敬重也不是说我们就是不过问他们所做的一些事情。
Pastors have and will be disqualified and no longer fit for ministry.
有些牧师是他们到一个地步，他们不适合在教会牧养。
It might be immorality.
可能是他们有不当的行为。
Financial stuff. They're doing bad things with money.
或者他们在他们的金钱的管理上不正确。
They may be...disobeying the commandments of God and the qualifications, being domineering. They're not gentle and a kind shepherd.
或者他们没有遵照神的话，像神的话要我们温柔，他们却是非常严厉对待人。
That happens a lot.
这经常的发生。
The domineering, mean pastor. Okay.
这个就是很霸道的。
You don't want a pastor like that.
okay. 我们不要这样的牧师。
Okay, you want a pastor who's strong and firm,
要一个很坚强的牧师,
but not mean.
但不是有恶意的。
Okay. You need someone who's willing to confront you if needed.
我们要一个能够挑战我们的。
But you know in the middle of that confrontation that he loves you.
但是在这挑战当中我们知道他爱我们。Okay.
So when a pastor does something wrong,
当牧师做错事的时候,
he may need to be removed.
他可能需要离职。
Matthew chapter 18 provides the basis for doing that.
马太福音十八章里面有说到这个。
Jesus says there, if your brother sins against you, go to him in private and tell him what he's done.
当你弟兄得罪你的时候，你需要去单独的去面对他，去跟他说。
If he admits what he's done and asks your forgiveness, you've won your brother, forget about it.
要是他承认的话，你就得着了你的弟兄。
If he doesn't listen, you go with one or two other witnesses.
要是他不承认，你就要带一两个其他的人一起去。
Those witnesses have to have witnessed what's happened. It can't just be your friends coming, hey, you know, they need to know this.
你所带的人需要是证人，他们目睹过这件事情的发生，不是随便一个人都可以。
If that person responds well to that, you've won your brother.
要是这个人他承认他的过犯，我们就得回赢得他。
Forget about it and move on.
我们就不需要再计较，可以。
If he doesn't listen to the three, take it before the church.
要是他不承认他的错的话，我们要带到教会的面前。
So the three witnesses, maybe some leaders in the church know this has happened. We announce it to the church, and out of a desire to love and care for and restore, not to embarrass, not to hurt.But to love and care for and restore, we appeal to the church to reach out to our sinning brother.
我们主要教会是要让他能够恢复与神的关系。我们不是为了要伤害他。
If they refuse to listen even to the church, we're to treat them as an unbeliever.
要是他不听教会的劝勉的话，我们就要把他当成是不信的弟兄、不信的人来看。
The reason is they're in disobedience to the Lord, proving, at least for that moment, they don't love him.
因为他们没有遵守神的话，所以就是他们不爱神。
Yeah, so for a pastor, okay, greater responsibility.
对牧师来说，这是更大的责任。Okay.
So, if I'm a young believer, and I steal some money out of the offering plate, but I'm not an elder, not an elder.
我从教会的奉献里面偷了一些钱。
Okay, that's a sin that needs to be confronted.
那是个罪，需要我们去面对。
As a young believer, I get caught, I go, and I say to the church leadership or whoever knows it, I'm so sorry, this was wrong, please forgive me.
这个人要是他承认他已经他偷了钱,
maybe it's just that one person that knows it.
要是只有一个人知道,
then what? Forgiveness, I give the money back, and we move on.
那我们就让他把钱还回来, 我们就原谅他, 我们就不再计较。
If I've been a pastor for 25 years,
但是要是这个人是一位牧师，已经牧会了25年。
And I reach in and take money.
那我还是偷了教会的钱。
Disqualified from ministry.
这个人就不适合在当牧师。
Does that make sense when I say that?
Yes.
Okay, all right. So here's what 1 Timothy 5:19 and 20 says. It says, do not admit a charge against an elder except on the evidence of two or three witnesses.First Timothy 5:19 and 20.
提摩太前书五章十九到二十节。You want me to read it?
Sure, I'll say it again.
提摩太前书五章十九二十节，控告长老的臣子，非有两三个见证就不要收。犯罪的人当在众人面前责备他，叫其余的人可以惧怕。
Okay, so immediately when a pastor does something sinful, you go right to step two. Okay, not step one where it's just an individual, you take two or three witnesses, okay, who see this.
当牧师长老犯罪的时候，我们就可以跳过第一步，我们马上就是两三个人去跟他证实这件事情。
The pastor who persists in sin, verse 20, rebuke them in the presence of all.
要是他不承认的话，我们就要在众人面前来责备他。
Okay, so...This honor and devotion that you show to your elders is not a unquestioning thing. Okay.
我们对长老牧师的敬重不是说我们什么都可以接受。
My hope and prayer is that I live another 25, 30 years and I'm able to do what I'm doing for the next 20 years.
我希望我在接下来的二三十年里面还能够继续做我现在做的。
But I know this wicked heart is capable of deep wickedness.
那我知道我的心是会犯罪的。
Therefore, I guard it.
所以我要保护
它。I have friends that hold me accountable.
我有朋友，他们我是对他们要交账。
Other pastors.
还有其他的牧师。
That help me out.
他们帮助我。
So I know I'm capable of massive sin.
因为我知道我自己，我有这个能力去犯罪。
Doesn't mean I'm not forgiven.
不表示说我没有被神赦免。
Can't lose my salvation.
我不能失去我的救恩。
But can sin massively.
但我也能够犯罪。
The Lord grant that that never happens in this church.
希望说在这教会里面不会发生。
No matter who the elder or pastor is.
不管牧师或长老是哪一位。
But your love for them.
我们对他们的爱。
Part of your honor for them is to see them walk in faithfully with Jesus themselves.
我们敬重他们，真的希望他们能够忠心的在神面前服事。
Okay. So, what we need to do as churches.
所以我们应该怎么做？
We need to find godly, qualified men.
我们要找到合格的尊重神的人。
Put them to the task of pastoring.
让他们来牧养。
And honor them as they do it.
然后在他们做的时候，我们要敬重他们。
You should memorize Hebrews 13:17.
我们要来要记得希伯来书十三章十七节。
Obey your leaders and submit to them.
Okay, 你们要依从那些引导你们的。
For they are keeping watch over your souls.
因为他们为你们的灵魂时刻警醒。
As those who will have to give an account.
好像那将来交账的人。
Let them do this with joy and not with groaning.
你们要使他们交的时候有快乐。
For that would be of no advantage to you.
若忧愁就与你们无益了。
Okay, amen?
Amen.
All right. Is this time to wrap up? No? Another 2 hours? Okay, questions? Either everyone's really confused or it's a good message, right?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in the church, what if you go to the pastor, but mm-hmm. the pastor refuses to obey, mm-hmm. and everyone else agrees, so what do you do?
So, it's hard, okay? So what you have found, this is the scenario is that Lee here has witnessed a pastor who's done something sinful, okay? Lee goes to the pastor, and the pastor refuses to acknowledge what he's done. And the rest of the church supports the pastor. Okay, so a couple of things. The instructions are clear. As hard as it is, you can't go to the pastor unless there's two or three witnesses. So if it's only you, yes, go, okay, but it can't be taken before the church unless it's two or three witnesses against the pastor. Okay, and that's a hard one. It really is. But there's a reason that passage is in there like that, because some people decide, hey, I don't like this pastor anymore. I'm going to accuse him of this. Okay, I'm not saying that's what's happening. So by God's grace, if the pastor is doing something that is sinful, more than one person will know about it. God is faithful in that too, okay? God does not let our sin hide. He doesn't, okay? And especially in the life of a pastor, he will reveal it. So there's two or three. It's affirmed, you go to them, and the rest of the church says, either I don't believe you, or I don't care. You and your family need to go to another church. Yes. Straight up. That's just where it's at. Okay? Yeah. Okay. That's an unhealthy church.
我刚才问的问题就是说，要是你发现说牧师做错了事情，你去跟他讲的时候，他不承认。他说不能一个人去，至少要有两三个人一起去。要是你没有见证人的话，他不承认的话，我们就不能带到教会面前。然后应该还有
教会人不支持，还是觉得他没错的话，
最后就是你跟你家人需要离开。
Let me say something careful, but I think it's wise. Okay. If your pastor is faithfully opening up the Bible and trying to teach faithfully, okay, you may not like his style of teaching, but you still need to support him. Does that make sense when I say that? Okay.
要是我们的牧师是忠心从神的话来教导我们的话，即使我们不喜欢他讲道的方式，我们还是要顺服。
So one of the most heartbreaking things that's happened to me as a pastor is we had a lot of young families, and 2/3 of them left in one weekend because they got called to go move somewhere else. Okay, Boulder is very expensive to live in.
对我来说最难过的就是，我们教会有很多年轻的家庭，在一个周末里面，三分之二的这些家庭就离开了，因为我们住的地方非常昂贵。
One of the two young families that were left decided to leave because they left.
还有其中一个剩下的家庭，他们也决定离开，因为这些人离开了。
That broke my heart.
那非使我非常心碎。
We don't desert the church.
我们不能离弃我们的教会。
When things aren't going the way we like them to go.
当事情不是按照我们想要的
，We love the church.
我们爱教会。
We want to see it strong.
我们希望教会能够坚壮。
We're willing to do the long and hard work to see it strong.
我们需要努力来使教会能够健康。
Even if my demographic isn't present in that church.
虽然我没有其他的同伴跟我在一起。
Amen?
Amen.
Okay. All right. Anything else?
还没有问题。
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you.
我们结束的，用一起祷告结束。首先，用中文祷告，让我为还是 Eric 同学祷告。父神，我们在您的圣座前为弟兄姐妹向你感恩，知道我们都是在主耶稣的救赎恩典里面，是同有一个盼望的，是同样宝贵救恩的。我们都是神家里面的属神的儿女，教导我们，帮助我们怎么样彼此相爱，在爱里面来建立自己的身体，这是我们的身体，是见证你的身体。求主，你就为您自己的荣耀，你继续在我们当中来成就奇事，让我们中间如果还有什么样要隔断我们的墙，求主耶稣您自己赦罪之恩，也让我们学习怎么样彼此包容、彼此相爱、彼此饶恕。在这为能够有这样的恩典机会，听到你自己话语解开来帮助，感恩。Again, we want to thank you for the teaching that help us to know we cannot by ourselves, but we can by your enabling that we love one another, and that's the sure sign of a living church willing to obey you. So may Lord, you keep helping us to love one another and to tear down whatever the middle wall can be, and help us to forbear one another. Again, I want to thank you for Pastor Eric. May Lord, you bless him, his family, and the ministry that he entrusted, that if ever he goes, he will upholding your word to bless the church and brother sisters that he is going to meet, he is going to serve. Thank you, Lord. Pray in Jesus' name. Amen.